السلام عليكم. This material is brought to you by المشكات Institute. All proceedings go to future development of المشكات programs. So please refrain from duplication and redistribution. Thank you. For upcoming programs, please visit www.almishkatinstitute.com. You are listening to Love Takes Time, a lecture by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Nainawi, presented by Al-Mishkat Institute in collaboration with Al-Madina Institute and ISCJ Youth Group.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما، والحقنا بعبادك الصالحين. أما بعد، فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Number one, I am very pleased and honored to be amongst you today. For all of you are dear, inshallah, and to me, and it's a pleasure that you allow me to speak to you. And I'm especially also honored because one of my teachers is sitting actually amongst you. Sheikh Sayyid Ahmed Al-Qata'ani, Hafizahu Allah Ta'ala, he's one of our shuyukh, and he's teaching me adab. In a sense, he's sitting in the back and I'm sitting in the front talking in front of him. Like the poet said about the ulama, وَتَرَاهُ يُصْغِي لِلْحَدِيثِ بِسَمْعِهِ وَبِقَلْبِهِ وَلَعَلَّهُ أَدْرَى بِهِ. You see them, and many of our shuyukh were like this. You see them listening to you while you're talking about the hadith, but they don't only listen to you with their ears, but also with their hearts, though they know it much better than you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Talking about love. That's what the brothers want me to talk about, since we are in that loving atmosphere today. It's an always a loving environment. Love is a human experience that touches the heart, the deep depth of the heart of every human being, really. It makes them feel like they're born again. Like they're new, they're rejuvenated, they're active, there's a flame of fire in them. They're on a sympathetic drive, medically speaking, not parasympathetic. Remember, sympathetic is fight and flight, parasympathetic is rest and digest. So they're on the sympathetic, they're on overdrive. Really, I don't think that people can live without love. Either people love themselves or love someone else. And if they don't love someone else, they usually are in love with themselves. Either in love with their fulfilling their own desires, and they're in love in that of that power, they're in love of collecting money. They're in love, there's always something that people love. And because they say, the poets say, that life without love is not worth anything. Huh? The poet said, وَالْعِيشُ دُونَ الْعِشْقِ أَوْلَذْعِ الْهَوَىٰ عِيشٌ يَلِيقُ بِمِثْلِهِ التَّأْبِينُ. Living without love. Yeah, of course, he's talking about the love of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. That poet, that specific poet is talking about the love of the Sahaba. He says, وَالْعِيشُ دُونَ الْعِشْقِ أَوْلَذْعِ الْهَوَىٰ. The living without love. And the burning, feeling the burning, that burning sensation of love, as if someone is burning you with fire. عَيْشٌ يَلِيقُ بِمِثْلِهِ التَّعْبِينُ. Is a life that's worth being buried. It's not really life, it's like death. ولقد عشقتك واحتفت بك أضلعي وتاه بجمره الكانون. وفداء جمرك سيدي إن نفسي لها توق إلى لذعاته وسكون. And to that kind of burning with love, the poet says, my soul yearns to be burnt. وإذا سألت العاشقين فعندهم فيما رووه مبرر موزون. And everyone who is in love, they have a justification for what they do. لكن there are other people who always think other than that. The dunya that we live in, dear brothers and sisters, is a path that will come to an end. But then we don't know, the point is we don't know when will it end. All of us are on that road, that path, that will end. We all know that definitively. When will it end? We don't know. And that road is filled with holes on all sides. Ditches. And you know what the New Testament says, according to what they called New Testament. When the blind lead the blind, they both fall in the ditch. Well, in that trip, in that journey of life, as we call it, because life is really a journey. It is a journey. And that journey will end. There will be a day when that journey ends, though nobody knows when their day is up. Therefore, yani just to get off point for just a minute, how much do I have time? 1 hour. One person came to Sayyidina Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali. He says, I just bought a house from this man. They brought him with him. He says, can you please write me the contract for this house? Just so, you know, it's official. I have a contract of sale. Sayyidina Ali looked at him. He saw that the dunya is in his eyes. You know how some people, when you look at them like cartoons, you see dollar signs in their eyes instead of eyeballs. Cling, dollar signs. You see that some people. And no, that's their love and passion. When Amir al-Mu'mineen looked at that and saw this, he said, Bismillah ar-Rahman, you want a contract? He says, yeah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ishtara mayyitun min mayyitin. A dead man bought from another dead man, daran, a house, fi baldati al-muznibin, in the city of sinners. وسكت الغافلين, and the street of those who are absent from the mention of Allah. That house has four borders. أما الأول فينتهي إلى الموت. The first border will end at death, and the second will end at قبر, grave, and the third will end up at حساب, and the fourth line of this house will end either إلى الجنة أو إلى النار. It's a journey, regardless what you think of it. And I know sometimes because we're so busy thinking about, we are so obsessed in this journey that we call life. You know what it is? As someone made it, it's like a jail. But it's a huge jail. A huge prison. With rivers and mountains and sunshines in that river, in that prison system. But everybody is in that jail. And in that jail, people eat and drink and they are born and they have families and all these things. And over the time, because they don't know what to call it, so they called it life. That jail is really secured, maximum security. And the Anbiya came and gave us a crack of light to see what it is really out of this jail wall. There's much more to this than this jail that we see. But anyway, let's take it as a journey. On that journey of life that we call, and which will end one day, regardless how long it takes, it will end. And usually people don't know when it ends. Usually it ends despite their will. You can't tell Malakul Maud, give me a rain check. Please come back, please. I'm not ready yet. There's always two important components of any journey.